What's up, it's Jay here, and one of the most common comments that I get over and over and over again is, Jay, how the hell do I find a good niche to target for my website? And often I get messages from people who send me their sites asking me what I think, and they put a lot of effort into making the site look awesome, but they picked something that's so competitive and saturated that they're gonna have a real uphill battle trying to actually get any visitors to the site. So in this video, I'm gonna show you exactly how I go about finding low competition, obscure niches, and I'm gonna give you a real example of what these kind of niches look like so you know what to look for. So let's jump into it. In a nutshell, what we want to try to do is find a niche that sits in that perfect middle ground between not being super, super vague and broad, but also not being so hyper-specific that we don't actually have any room to grow. In other words, we want to get specific with our niches, but not too specific. So for example, let's say you wanted to target the pets niche. The pets niche is actually one that if you did well with, you could stand to make a lot of money. People are passionate about their pets and they spend a hell of a lot of money on them too. But instead of creating some kind of all-in-one pet site where you try to target literally every kind of pet under the sun, you'd be much better off trying to target one category of pet and doing it really fucking well. And even better, instead of going for something super obvious like cats or dogs, why not go for something even more obscure like bearded dragons or capybaras, a type of guinea pig that's so obscure that most people have probably never heard of them. But you can guarantee that they're gonna have a hell of a lot less competition, they still get searched a ton, and the people that actually have them as pets are still gonna be crazy passionate about them too. So instead of setting up a craft blog, why not set up one about knitting or cross stitch? Instead of setting up a website about sports, why not set up one about tennis or baseball? Instead of setting up a website about gardening, why not go for something really left of center like aquaponics? Remember though, we don't want to go so random and obscure that we have no room to grow down the track. So whilst bearded dragons might be good, we don't want to create a whole website about the best cage size for bearded dragons or something so obscure like that. Try to find that perfect middle ground. So now that we have all that out of the way, let's go through how we can actually evaluate the demand and competition for a niche idea. And to do this, we'll first need to get our hands on a good keyword tool. Simply put, keyword tools just allow us to type in a word or phrase and see how many times that word or phrase gets searched for in Google each month. Now there are a lot of different options when it comes to keyword tools, but for this tutorial, I'm just gonna use a free keyword tool that should be able to do everything you want when you're just starting out, called Uber Suggest. You just type in whatever your niche idea is, hit search, and boom, you'll find out how many times that term gets searched for in Google each month. So when I type in bearded dragons, for example, I can see that around 300,000 people a month are searching for bearded dragons. Below that, you'll also see a whole bunch of related keywords that you'll be able to target down the track on your website. It's important with any niche that we not only have a good main keyword to target, but we also have a lot of different related keywords like these that we can then eventually create content about. So let's say, for example, I was thinking about setting up a website in the sports niche. Sport is another example of a really profitable niche. People are crazy passionate about sports and they also spend a lot of money on them too. But instead of just targeting something as broad and general as sports, I might try to narrow it down a bit. So maybe I would look at something like soccer. But even soccer is still kind of vague. Sure, it gets a lot of searches each month, but the competition is obviously fierce in Google with sites like ESPN on the first page. And on top of that, most of the people that are searching for soccer are looking for live score updates on games that are currently being played, which is going to be pretty hard for us to create good evergreen content around. And by evergreen, I mean content that's going to be just as relevant a year from now as it is today. Furthermore, if we search for soccer in the Ubersuggest keyword tool, we can see that the average page on the first page of Google has 1,000 links pointing towards it. In other words, there's over 1,000 websites linking to each of these sites. And generally speaking, the more links they have, the harder it's going to be to beat a website, because more links equals better authority in Google's eyes and better ranking. So basically, targeting soccer probably wouldn't be the best idea. But if I scroll down in the keyword tool, then I can see a bunch of related keywords that I can use to get some ideas on how I can narrow my niche down a bit more. And eventually, I might stumble on something more niche and obscure, like soccer drills. Now, this keyword obviously gets a lot fewer searches than just soccer itself, but it's these type of obscure keywords that are generally far lower in competition and much easier to build an authority site around. For example, if I search for soccer drills in the Ubersuggest tool, then I can see that the average page on the first page of Google for this term has just 13 links pointing towards it, which honestly is crazy low. And if you don't think that you can get more than 13 links pointing towards your site, then you need to be in a different game altogether. And just to remind you of how low this is, when we search for soccer, each result on the first page of Google had over 1,000 links pointing towards it. The best way though to truly evaluate how competitive a niche is to just search for it in Google and look at the results yourself. For example, if we search for soccer drills, we can see that whilst there's some decent websites on here, they're not exactly ESPN. The first result on here is just a pretty simple website that only has 150 words of unique content. Unique content is simply content that doesn't appear on any of their other pages. Generally, Google favors websites that put a lot more content on a website. So if you put 500 words or even 1,000 words, you'd already have an advantage over this website. Then we can also check out their social accounts to see how much action they're getting on there. If I search for their Facebook page, I can see that they have just under 4,000 likes. Now, this might sound like a lot, but if you've seen my video about how to get millions of Facebook fans, that you'll know that this is actually relatively low and pretty easy to obtain. If you missed that video and want to check it out, you can head over to lazyassstoner.com/getfacebookfans to watch the full thing. Furthermore, when I look at this Facebook page, I can also see that many of the links that they've shared out are really poorly optimized for Facebook. You can see with this post, for example, they haven't optimized their image at all for Facebook. The title isn't anything catchy or clickbaity, and they only have 2 shares on the post. If you compare this to the page that I made as an example for my Facebook tutorial, then you'll see how much of a difference that having a good title and thumbnail can make. This post that I made as an example achieved over 100 reshares and over 300 likes, despite the page not having many more likes than the soccer one. Next, if I head over to Pinterest, I can see that they haven't even set up a Pinterest account. And as for Twitter, they do have one, but it's not exactly very active and their posts don't have much traction either. And the point I'm getting at is, if this site is ranking in the number one spot for this term, then this is looking like a pretty damn low competition right for the picking niche. It has hardly any links pointing to it from other sites. It doesn't have much unique content on the site, and the social accounts are barely active. Then if we go further down the list, we can see much of the same thing. This site has just 160 words of unique content on it. And whilst their Facebook page has a few more fans than the first one, they're still getting basically no engagement on any of their posts. And once again, their Twitter account is getting next to no action. So far, this niche is looking pretty damn good indeed, but we're only just getting started. Because whilst it's nice to see that our main keyword is relatively low in competition, we're also going to want to target a lot of other related keywords on our site and build content around those keywords. And often these keywords are going to be even lower in competition and even easier to rank for. So head back to your keyword tool of choice and type in your keyword idea and take a look at the related keywords that turn up. And here I can see we've got quite a few keywords that get a decent number of searches that actually look pretty juicy. We've got soccer drills for kids, we've got soccer passing drills, soccer drills U10, soccer drills U8, soccer dribbling drills, and a bunch of other stuff too. And here's where things get really interesting, because if we actually search for some of these related keywords in the Google search engine, we can see that some of these terms are crazy obscenely low in competition. For example, if I search for U8 soccer drills, yet again, many of them are the same websites as before with very few words on them. And what's more, if we look at the first few pages, we can start to even see some websites that don't even have U8 soccer drills in the title at all. And some of the designs on these sites are so ugly, they make me want to rip my eyes out. Furthermore, they don't have any social presence at all. This is the definition of a low competition, profitable keyword. And if we search for soccer drills U8 in the keyword tool, we can see that the average page on the first page of Google for this term has just 6 links pointing towards it. And it's the exact same story with many of these other related keywords. So if you were to say set up a website targeting soccer drills as your main keyword, and then create a page about each of these related keywords, so a page about soccer drills U8, a page about soccer drills U10, a page about soccer passing drills, and so on, and then create better content with some nice images, with some nice formatting, and get some more links and social presence than these other sites, then you would stand a very real chance at outranking and beating all of these other sites. And there are so many of these related keywords that we could target that when you add them all up, it would add up to a lot of traffic to a website. But another way to find even more good obscure related keywords is to then take some of these sites that are appearing on the first page of Google, type those sites into our keyword tool, and then we can see what other terms they're actually ranking for. Often, this is a great way to find super obscure keywords that you wouldn't have thought of in a million years. For example, if we take a look at this keyword, 433 formation, and then if I type that keyword into my keyword tool, I can see that the average page on the first page of Google for this term has just 1 link pointing towards it. I'll say that again because you should really let that sink in. That has just 1 freaking link pointing towards the average page on the first page of Google. And on top of that, if I search for this term in Google, some of the websites are so bad, it's hilarious. Much of the content is super thin, and most of them do not scream, "This is an authority website." Seriously, if you think you can't create a website that doesn't look and feel better than this kind of website, then you obviously haven't seen my How to Build a Website video, which you can check out over at lazyassstoner.com/build. If you've never built a website and you think this kind of website is hard to build a better version of, then you really should check that out. I'll say that again, it's lazyassstoner.com/build. Furthermore, I could then also take that formation keyword to find even more related keywords in this way. If I take a look at soccer formation 9v9, which is obviously for 9v9 players, then I can see that the average page on the first page of Google for this term has just 3 links pointing towards it. And in Google, there's less than 50,000 results showing up, which again is nothing. And once again, most of the sites that are showing up in Google are super thin on content and have basically no social presence whatsoever. In fact, to prove just how easy it would be to create a better version of these soccer websites, here's one I quickly whipped up as an example just to show you what a better version would look like. And you can see it's got better images, better formatting, longer content, and all that stuff that's gonna really help me to rank better than these other sites. And it only took me a few minutes to set this up too. I literally just grabbed a HostGator account, installed WordPress, installed a theme, and spent a few minutes setting everything up. If you don't have a web hosting account yet, then you can also head over to hostoffer.com and use the coupon LAZYCOUPON at the checkout to get a HostGator account at a massively reduced price. You'll get your first month for just 1 cent, or up to 60% off your total order. Full disclosure, when you use this link and coupon code, I'll get a commission, which is how I'm able to justify making my videos for free, but you also get the best discount on a hosting account that you're gonna find anywhere. Basically, by learning how to really drill down into these kind of low competition niches, you can find all kinds of obscure low competition keywords. If you look at all of the sites that I put out on this channel as an example, you'll see I do just the same thing too. With my numerology case study that I made a video about a while back, I'm targeting all sorts of obscure, random keywords, whether it be soul urge number 1 or master number 11 or whatever. The same thing goes for my affirmation case study. I've got stuff like love affirmations and daily affirmations, and it's no coincidence that I rank for many of these terms. So often people will just pick a really broad niche like crafts or whatever and set up a site and then wonder why the hell they're not getting any traction, when in reality they would have such an easier time if they just picked something that's lower competition. It's something that sounds simple, but if you actually put this stuff into practice, you'd be amazed at how much of a difference it really makes. And if you'd like more information on exactly how I set up profitable niche websites, then you can head over to lazyrstoner.com/newbie to get my free newbie crash course. Until next time, peace. Thank you.